Hi, everyone. Welcome along to LVSA Conference TV, I guess. You're all very welcome. I'm Cullum Cronin from the Adventures in Advising podcast, and I am delighted and excited to be joined by two wonderful colleagues from LVSA today. I might let you both introduce yourselves so that viewers can have an idea of who they are listening to. Iris, we might start with you.
Thank you, Cullum. My name is Iris Brooks. I work for Maastricht University. I'm the Coordinator of Academic and Student Advising, and I've been part of the organizing committee for the LVSA conference.
Thanks, and my name is Miriam Nederveen, and I'm an academic advisor at the University of Groningen and the Protestant Theological University in Groningen, and happy to be a board member of the LVSA and very proud of the team of Iris who is organizing our conference.
Well, Iris and Miriam, thank you both for taking the time to chat to me. And Iris, I've had the opportunity to speak to you a little bit about some of the things that delegates will get to experience. And there are a lot of exciting things planned. So maybe you could tell me, both of you, you know, what is it that delegates and attendees can look forward to over the course of the conference?
Thank you. Yeah, of course, we've got a nice lineup of interesting sessions planned. This will be the first member-driven conference for the LVSA, so that means that our members will drive most of the sessions, which is a new format for LVSA, and I think we're looking forward to that. And I think most of the presenters are actually very enthusiastic and looking forward to that as well. We have a few interesting collaborations between UCAT, the British Organization of Advising and Tutoring, and LVSA, so we're also looking forward to those joint sessions. And in order to create somewhat of a feeling of actually coming together, we have an online platform where people can meet. It's called the Advising Hub, or GatherTown, which is the format it's provided in. And we hope that our members, but also the British members, can meet each other there, have discussions there, etc. To also make sure that, again, normally during a conference, you go for a walk with someone or you go outside. We also have a bingo to make sure that people still get a little bit of an exercise and a little bit of a fresh air and some outside experience as well. So we have a bingo that we invite all participants to take part in, and we have nice gifts to send out afterwards.
Fantastic. That sounds really good. And Miriam, from your side then, what are you excited about delegates experiencing over the next few days?
I'm very excited to have the possibility to meet so many academic advisors from the Netherlands and Britain, and I think it's just very nice to take some time to reflect on yourself and on your work, and because normally you just continue working with all the students and all your emails and all your meetings, and now you have the time to think about yourself, to reflect, and to think about steps to take to do your work a little bit better after the conference. So that's why I like it so much.
Yeah, I think it is good to get the chance to press pause a little bit and maybe reflect on the past year in particular. And I know, Iris, that there is also going to be a LinkedIn group for both LVSA and UCAT, and you can see some of the details on the screen there. And there is also a dedicated LVSA Twitter account, and you can see the conference hashtag and the YouTube channel there. And from what I am led to believe, that attendees in the Advising Hub in GatherTown will also be able to watch conference television as part of that experience. So there are many, many things to look forward to over the coming days. And I think it will be a great opportunity for learning and for interaction. And the fact that, you know, it is allowing delegates to experience both LVSA and UCAT, I think is a really exciting development. And hopefully a pointer towards the future, because this is something we could all definitely use, is more international interaction. I'm all for that. So I want to say thank you both. I hope the conference is a resounding success. I have no doubt it will be, given the people behind it and some of the sessions that I know are planned. And I look forward to talking to you over the coming days.
Yeah, look forward to seeing you in the hub.
Yeah, thanks.